Hello everybody, welcome to Fat Buddies, your FIFA Ultimate Team podcast, trading podcast, here with Jake. I'm Florian. How are you, Jake? What are we expecting these days?
I'm doing great. FIFA 21 has been off to a great start. I actually ran a poll recently that asked people what they think about the gameplay, and they're putting it like a 7 out of 8, 7 to 8 out of 10, which is really, really high, much higher than 20, higher than FIFA 19. So I think cumulatively, people are saying it's the best gameplay we've had in years, so hopefully it stays that way. And I think people are really enjoying FIFA to start. They're enjoying these new ones to watch, cards, they're enjoying trading, and they're enjoying the gameplay more than the last few years. So FIFA is really blowing up. It's doing incredibly well, and it's making me happy as a creator, and I hope it's doing the same for you.
Yeah, so just so you know, guys, you're giving very good grades to FIFA because you didn't play the first weekend league yet. So, guys, everybody's like praising FIFA until the first one or two weekend leagues.
Yep.
So that's the time when people are breaking the controllers. Second of all, bear with us today. I discussed with Jake. We're gonna keep it short and with a lot of trading questions and tips. We want to go to what was going on since our last podcast, so since last Thursday with the release of the ones to watch, which Jake has it on the screen, and also how we can make more coins this next week. So first question we have on the screen, I see the ones to watch team, 11 players team. How was it perceived, and maybe we can go a little bit through what were the moves with the release of on Friday of this team?
Yeah, sure. So looking at the team, I think it is what everyone expected. I'd say the main card that is missing is Everton's James Rodriguez. I think he's going to get an SBC of sorts, but he's really hyped up. I think he's going to play well for them. He already got an inform, and I know the fan base is really loving that. So I think that he's going to get an SBC of sorts. He's probably the main one I would think of as moving. As missing. And then other than that, I think it's what we expected. Rodrigo, I think they're including a lot of attackers, right, because they're more prone to make a team of the week from scoring goals, getting assists, etc. Even the defenders look great in Florenzi and Semedo. Semedo is one of the preferred right backs still by pros. I know that for a fact this year. We have a couple of pros in Discord, and they've been telling me he's definitely preferred. So that card could be incredible with an inform and very costly. In terms of how to make coins with this team, guys, one of the main ways, and EA is just handing it to us this year, is investing in some of these gold cards that go out of packs. So there's two ways we can do it. And Florian, you can see the screen too, right?
Yeah.
Okay, it's perfect. So there's two ways we can do this. And the first one is looking at cards that are going to be SBC fodder. So Florenzi isn't very meta. He's not going to be used a ton this year. Not many people are even rocking League One or Italy to start their teams. You probably haven't seen him in many teams at all. So not many people are going to use this card. However, he has great links because he's in League One and he's also Italian. So he links to a lot of SBC fodder. So if an SBC comes out in the coming days that requires an 81 or 82 rating, I would suspect that he rises because he's going to be out of packs and he's going to be needed. This just happened recently with an inform. His name was Halstenberg. We invested in him at 2K. He went all the way to 4K. So I'm not saying this card will double for sure, but I'm guessing he can easily go to 3K. So if you guys want an easy kind of like a bulk investment, try to get a handful of him, 20 of him on, put him on your timeline if you're transfer list if you're not using him. And he should see a rise too, because I know we're still expecting, I believe, Matt Tweedy as an SBC, and I can't see that being high rated because he's in the MLS this year. So I think he'll be used pretty quickly. So you can invest in him as SBC fodder. Same with Vidal. I don't think he's holding a heavy price. And then the other way you can do it, guys, is you can invest in meta cards that are going out of packs that might have a pretty distinct separation in price from their current ones to watch. So for this, I'm just going to show you an example because it's a little bit easier. And the best example I have is actually Timo Werner. And Werner had a perfect scenario for investing because Calvert-Lewin's Player of the Month came out on Friday morning. I think it was, well, actually, I think it was around 3 p.m. UK that it launched. Yeah. It was 9 a.m. my time, yeah. So I say morning. But it was 3,
yeah, yeah.
It was 3 p.m.
Don't worry,
UK.
Don't worry, our fan base in US understands it.
Exactly, all my soccer fans, let's go, guys.
Yeah, yeah.
So basically, it was a perfect combination because on that Friday, Werner had actually dropped his gold card. He dropped from around 270K all the way to 240K. And I looked at that. And I kind of laugh. So I invested, I think, in around 10 of him at 240K. And later that evening, after he went out of packs, he went all the way up to 280K, okay? And that's simply because the first day of his ones to watch, this card is really in demand. It's very desirable. People are really liking Werner this year, too. So this card, when it first came out, was 750K plus. So everyone's like, oh, shoot, I can't afford that. I'm just going to go buy the gold card. And with everyone doing that, it made him rise 45K in just one day. So when there's a distinct separation in price from the ones to watch and the gold, people will go down to that gold card.
So very good advice here, Jake. And guys, as you can see, just a short comment here. You can listen to us on Google, Apple Podcasts,
yep.
On Spotify. But if you wanna watch also what Jake is showing on the screen, you can watch us on YouTube. Very important that Jake showed us until now two very different price points investment methods. Let's say the same investment method,
yep.
But one for, let's say, 2K with player out of packs. And one, let's say, for a bigger budget. He said he bought 10 Werners. You need like 2.5 million coins to do that. But mm-hmm. You see, it depends where you are with your budget here.
Yep.
And I see now you are showing the ones to watch first team. And
yep.
Maybe let's go a little bit through what happened at the release of this team, because we have some very good cases with Odegaard and Partey being also in Team of the Week this week. So I'm going to ask you if you predicted, I mean, if you followed the fact that Odegaard and Partey could have been in Team of the Week, and how did you manage that that thing?
Yeah, so this is a great question. And right now, there's a ton going on in trading. There are Team of the Week cards. There's ones to watch cards. There's ones to watch going out of packs. There's a lot to keep track of, but I knew during Odegaard's game, I actually knew when he was playing, I said, watch his game, his ones to watch could go up if he plays well. And sure enough, his ones to watch rose because he actually had a 2-assist game. I think Haaland had a hat trick, but he already had a current in form, so there was literally no chance of him getting another one this early.
Yeah.
So people knew that Odegaard would get that in form. So what happened was his card went up around 5 to like 8K after the game and during the game, as people witnessed it and were like, okay, I think he's going to get an inform. And then the day after, which would be Sunday, Squad Battle Rewards came out, and that brought a lot of supply onto the market because we also get pre-order packs at the same time. So his price remained extremely steady during it. And this is actually something that I forgot about just because I was focused on so much going on in the market. That was a perfect time to invest. I did not say to invest there, honestly, because I forgot to. Mm-hmm. But it's a great time to invest during that Squad Battle Rewards Sunday evening time if you think he's going to make predictions. So what happened was during that time frame, he was around 27K, okay? And then as people started seeing predictions, whether it's on FUTBIN itself, which we're looking at, or Team of the Week predictors on Instagram or Twitter, he kept making it. So people really assumed he was going to get in, and they started buying his card in excitement and hype of that event. So he actually went from right around 26K to 50K in the coming days, which was way higher than I think anyone expected, because look at this card. It's not that great. And
yeah,
so you could have made almost double your money on any budget, because he was pretty easy to get at 26K. And his situation is a lot different than Partey. So that was the way you would approach Odegaard. For someone you know who is getting a Team of the Week, you'd want to invest the earlier the better, because as people start hyping it up, as predictions come out, he's going to naturally raise in value. Partey is a whole different scenario, and it was a much different situation. Partey played too late to get in Team of the Week predictions. I believe his game was on Monday or Tuesday. I think it was Monday.
Monday, yeah.
His game was on Monday, and predictions were already coming out. Usually people base it off weekend games already, so He had two assists as well, right? And he had a pretty good shot at getting in, but it was kind of late, so we don't know what games EA wanted to include, what games they didn't want to include, but he definitely had a shot of being in. And then what happened, guys, was yesterday morning, Wednesday morning, you saw him start to rise in price. And I can actually pull up his card here for you. It should show it nicely on the graph for us. So Wednesday morning, people started getting a team of the week leaked out to them pretty early. I didn't really receive that, but some people do. Some people have connections at EA or people making graphics or something that would tell them they did it. So as you see here, guys, Party is naturally rising in price until he has a really sharp rise in the morning. Do you see this? So he went all the way from 96K, which is his normal price, all the way up to like one, let's call it 120. And that to me would indicate that something is going on. So someone knew something that would mean he's going to have an inform. And then it started to come out that in fact he was. So he started seeing some pretty sharp rises. So he got all the way up to like 150. This is before Team of the Week was officially announced. And then people were like, okay, that's good profit. From here, I'll sell. And this brought his price back down. And as he came back down to around the 130K mark, I actually bought back into it right here. I thought to myself, Party is not going to get an inform in packs because he's got a ones to watch currently, so this he can only have one special in packs. And 130 just looks low for this card. So I actually bought in about right here. And right after announcement, he peaked, and it won't show it here because it was really brief, but he peaked at like 180 to 190K. And I sold a lot at 179. I sold some at 175. I sold one at 165. So I really varied it there. So Parties was much a different scenario, guys, because he got hyped up until the last second because it was a surprise factor, whereas Odegaard was kind of like a shoe-in and people fully expected him to be in. So those are two different ways you can profit off it. And I would just think to yourself, is everyone else aware of this event, like Odegaard, or are people going to be surprised if he in? That's the big difference.
Yeah, and I wanna take a little bit of the time, Jake, to tell a bit of my experience with these cards. Because, you know, guys, So maybe last year I traded more. This year I don't really have the time to do it often because of my job, and I'm trying to spend. I'm trying more to invest than to do daily trading and stuff like this.
Yeah.
So if you remember, guys, from the last episode, I was having like a lot of Rodrigos in my transfer list because he didn't have a price update, and during the weekend I think his price got upgraded, and he went to maybe 37K, something like this, at some point. And at that point I cleared my transfer pile from gold Rodrigos. And as you can see, I'm wearing a Romanian jersey t-shirt. So we played against Odegaard in Nations
League. Yeah, you were watching that closely
on Sunday. So it was very easy for me to watch the game. I was watching for Romania, of course. I was watching the game. First goal, I see Odegaard passing to Haaland, and they scored. And at that point, I saw Norway playing, and I knew they will score a lot of goals against us. I bought like 25 Odegaards right away. Yep. It was a very risky move. More based on how many goals we will get and how good Odegaard will play.
Yeah.
During the game, I've realized that Haaland is getting three goals. Sure. But he was already in Team of the Week. And there was also Charlotte, who had like a better grade than Odegaard. But I didn't think too much about it. I still had them on my transfer pile.
Sure.
And Monday morning, Sunday evening, and towards Monday morning, I noticed that a lot of predictors on Twitter and on Instagram are putting Odegaard in their predictions.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And I thought to myself, hey, if they are hyping him up also, there's no reason to sell him so fast.
Yep.
I kept him until Tuesday, and I said, okay, now is the time to sell. I sold him at around... at around 38k. So I almost doubled.
Yeah.
Not doubled, but 10k I made on each card.
Yep.
But I sold, I would think I sold too early, because in the next day he reached 50k. That was a little bit too much. I didn't expect that. And during that day, exactly what you said about Partey, I didn't buy too many Parteys. I bought only two of them.
Yep.
And I did this switch into waiting for the release of the team, and made like 20 or 30k on two Parteys also there. So for me, this week was very easy, because I've bought on some Odegaards. I got lucky also with the predictions, and also with Partey. So I've made some coins just by this.
Yep.
And these were like my only ways to do coins this week, but I was happy with what I've achieved.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great approach to trading right now. And I think what's important to note is that there's not very many special cards. So when there is an opportunity for some of these special cards to move or have a good game or get in team of the week, they're going to move a lot because everyone is focused on them. This happened with Haaland, how he got a team of the week early on, and I bought his gold card, and everyone bought into his gold card later because they knew he would be out of packs and got excited about it. Same thing happened with Odegaard. This card went higher than I think any trader would have predicted in the hype. Because, guys, going from like 25 to 40K it's nice. I would even say it's natural. But going that extra 10K to 50, you know how many people would have to buy this card? Like, it's hundreds and hundreds of cards that people are buying. So it was a surprise to me. There's people that lost a lot of coins too doing this. And there's people that trade ones to watch that are a little bit risky like that. Lastly, I think talking about ones to watch trading, I just wanted to cover a way you can approach it going forward to kind of wrap up.
Sure.
Wrap up this section. And this ones to watch, teams one goes out of pack tomorrow, guys, and they have, some of them have games on Saturday. And if you guys want a really safe, I think, investment, safe, low risk, if you buy some of these cards before tomorrow and you hold until their games and sell in the hype of their games, or if they get announced in the starting lineups, I think will be enough to make profit. If you're also more of a risky type of trader, if you want to hold into the game, if you think someone's going to have a great performance or score goals, like someone like Bale, I think he plays on Saturday, and if you think he's going to have good performance, if you hold his card and he does, that card could easily rise 80 to 100K if he has a good performance. So that's a more risky approach. But if you want a safe way to trade these cards, buy either after their games continuously, after they have a game where they don't perform particularly well or don't do much of anything of interest, you can buy them and then sell before their next game. It almost always works out for a slight margin. And just think of who's going to perform the best, who's got the most hype. Out of this team, I think Bale's really important. If this Manchester Telles plays well, I think he'll rise a lot. Werner, of course, could jump 100 to 200K. So think about who people would be excited about. But you even saw a car like Odegaard double, and people are not that excited about him, in my opinion.
Yeah, no, this is a very good advice, Jake, and I even recommend, guys, if you like football and you're watching the games, for example, myself, there is Liverpool against Everton playing on Saturday, I think,
yep,
in the afternoon Europe time. So I'm gonna watch that game. So I'm gonna keep my eyes on Alan. So if he scores a goal or if he makes an assist or something like that, I'll be there to buy. We discussed about this last time.
Yep.
You need to be like very fast to buy
totally
him. If you buy him like 2 minutes after he scored, you're already buying from the people who are selling already.
Exactly.
So make sure you buy in time here. And one other thing, because you said about out of packs investing,
mm-hmm,
I've made a move today. So I've sold everything.
Oh, sure.
Everything which I talked about earlier, I sold it, and I've got like probably 1 million coins invested.
Nice.
Now.
Mm-hmm.
And I've bought into some Rodrigos. And I will tell a little bit I'm not like advising this, I'm just telling you my thought on that.
Totally,
so
go for it.
So Rodrigo is probably, I'm not sure, but maybe if you go to popular players, maybe
sure,
he's
I'll go
the
to
most
it.
popular Maybe he's the most popular gold player.
He's definitely top five. Yeah, he's been top five consistently, right up there. Yep. Yeah. He's like a number one, two.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So personally, I've bought at around 37, 38K. Mm-hmm. I bought it last. I bought him last night before he was announced into Wants to Watch.
Yep.
I was expecting him to be there, and he has two very very nice advantages. We are having weekend league this weekend, and a lot of people are trying to compete in this, and they need a good attacker. He's a very good attacker. And second of all, he links very easily between La Liga and Premier League. I'm expecting him to rise a little bit more. Not sure about that, but because I have a lot of them, even if he rises like 5K, I'm happy with that. I will see how that goes.
It looks really safe from my perspective, and I like that, guys, because Florian is basing it off of two popular players, which, to be honest, I'm not 100% sure how this tab is configured. I don't know if it searches from players. I don't know if it's bids, or I don't know exactly what it is, but all I know is that these players are very, very popular. They're getting bought and sold a ton, and it makes sense. If you look at this list, everyone is interested in this list. They love this party. Gomez is like the most popular center back this year because he's affordable compared to Van Dijk. But yeah, and what would really help Florian's cause here, guys, is what I talked about before, is the price of his ones to watch. If Rodrigo one to watch is upwards of 150 to 200K, especially in those first few days, that's just going to help his cause because people don't want to make that big of a jump. The smaller the gap is, the less room for a rise they have, right? Because if someone says, oh, it's only a 50K difference between ones to watch and gold, I'll just go with the ones to watch. That's not what you want to have happen. But other than that, Florian's basis is awesome. I think this card's really hyped right now, too. I think Matt HD really loves him. He raves about him.
And I also play him in my squad. I know what he can do. So he's not, I believe I'm going to try him. I'm going to try Weekend League this weekend. So he's not going out of my team.
Yeah.
So if I'm thinking like that, I'm also thinking some other people are playing him there. So that's one reason. I will see how that goes out, how that plays out, guys. And we'll talk about it in the next podcast next week.
Yeah, I really like it. I think it's a nice, safe move. Mm-hmm.
The next move, I'm not sure when I will do the next move, but next move would be, as said, if I'm watching any games on this weekend, during this weekend, to be sure I'm on a transfer market very fast to buy one or two one-to-watch players if they score a goal during this game. So that's like the moves for the next week.
Exactly.
Something else happened, let's say this week, and I want to ask you how to proceed maybe in the future with this. We had some SBCs.
Yep.
And let's say these are not the SBCs that would influence too much the market. So we had Thiago Silva, and we had Thiago Silva, I believe it was on Friday.
Mm-hmm.
We had some daily SBCs which required like a certain nation. We had Axel Witsel, flashback player. I know it's early for, let's say, the father investing, how would you approach this part with the SBCs for the future?
Yeah, good question. So guys, the only player out of the list Florian gave that really moved a lot of SBC fodder across at least both consoles was actually this Ansu Fati. And I think he's really hyped in real life because he's so young. He's got such star power behind him. And then, of course, he actually already had an inform, so this upgrade's already really nice. I mean, he's got a card quite similar to actually Saint-Maximin inform. So if you compare those two, they're actually really close. I've heard great things about him as well. So he's the first one to actually move fodder prices, because right now we're just getting pretty much constant or a lot of supply, and there's just not enough out that is going to sustain it. Like Florian said, Thiago Silva, I know he's cheap. I think he's only an 82 rated squad, but no one wants this card in their team with 59 pace. Yeah. No one's going to use him. Calvert-Lewin, I think we got that Watkins inform around the same time, and they're really comparable cards. You can even see here by the likes and the dislikes that it's not very well received. That's often what I look at for it. Yeah. Same with this Witzel. They're doing flashbacks a little bit different this year, where it seems like they focused them on a certain part of their career. So Witzel got an upgrade, but it was more so on the attacking side of things. And I think that when people think of Witzel, they think of a CDM almost, like a defensive-minded player.
Yeah, exactly.
So, yeah, I think that not many people were looking to complete him. So right now, SBC fodder is still really low. But just know that the next time at least, there's a really in-demand SBC that is going to rise. And SBC fodder has a lot of room to go up, guys. And I'm telling you this specifically for like 86 plus rated players. Because right now, there's not a ton of options to use. And as we get further into the year, there will be. But right now, a lot of players don't hold SBC fodder prices because they're too good. Like this Alba. Later in the year, he'll be used for SBCs, but he's too good right now. Same with De Gea, right? Right now, he's too good. He's not going to be used. So for the 86s, you really only have Summer through Carvajal here to use. For 87s, there's only a few options too. Like Navas to Modric is about it. After that, you're getting into playable players like Laporte, Sancho, Lloris, Suarez. These guys aren't going to be used. They're too expensive. And then 88s is really fascinating to me. There's really only three to use, which is Handanovic, Kroos, and Kane. After that, they get too good and too expensive. No one's going to use Kimmich or Koulibaly or Dybala. Look at their price. They're way too expensive. So
yeah,
if a good SBC comes out, guys, that's 85 plus rated, you're going to see a lot of these guys go up because there's a lack of options right now. But to be honest, we just haven't really had many in-demand SBCs yet. Hopefully we get them soon.
Yeah, that's very good. I didn't know there are so few of them.
Right, yeah.
I've seen a comment probably on Twitter. Someone said that this year we have less high-rated players than last year. And now that I'm seeing the list, and yeah, you wouldn't put Ramos, Aguero, Neuer, or Courtois yet in an SBC. Also, some people told me that Benzema is quite good in game. So yeah, there are not so many options in high rated. I think we are expecting icons to be back in SBCs this year.
They are, in November.
That will happen in November. So yeah, we will have this discussion, let's say, later, guys. I'm not sure you should... you know, if you have like one or two players, that's good, but you shouldn't stack this kind of players yet. Just be very fast. If something very good shows up on a release by EA, be very fast to buy these players, because they will go like, we say in Romanian, they will go like hot bread.
Yeah, we say hot cakes. Yeah, guys. And that's just something to note. Like Florian said, I like if you see a good 86 or 87 squad, just know which 87 rated players that can use, like Chiellini, Busquets, Handanovic, and Kroos. Those are really like 4 of 10 options you can use. So if you buy them and they're at really similar prices to now, they got lots of room to rise, in my opinion. And yeah, right now SBC fodder is pretty quiet. I mean, you're seeing 85 rated center backs for like 5.5K. It just shows how little they're being used. And I think one of the next SBCs is a Matt Tuidi. I think we expect him, but he'll be low-rated too, like 81 or 82 probably, because he's in that off league. So yeah, hopefully EA roll out some good content this week.
Any other topics we want to touch today, Jake? I think we covered a lot into the once-to-watch trading part.
Mm-hmm.
Not sure if you have anything else. If not, we wish the best to our listeners or viewers.
Yeah, I don't have much more today. I mean, hopefully we find out some more tomorrow with the promo, and hopefully we get some good content then, and we can talk about it next week.
Yeah, guys. So we've Jay gave us a lot of tips today, a lot of players in different price points to invest into, different methods like out of packs or just buy them after the games and sell them next week if they have like a playing for a game there. So this is kind of it with Once to Watch. And also one extra thing I wanted to add.
Yep.
watch a little bit those predictions. If you
Totally.
see some predictions very early in the weekend, take a look on them, what those players did. Maybe you can buy one or two goals regarding that. Check the prices always on Footbin and see yourself the prices if they are worth it. I think
Yep.
there are a lot of moves you can do also there.
Agreed. It does work.
Thanks guys for watching and listening. This time shorter than before. I hope you guys enjoy it. Leave the comments if you have any questions. As always, stay safe and see you next time.
Thanks, guys.